Hello, this is Mark, M4 GPA, and today we're going to be programming the Hiroyasu IC-980 Pro using the manufacturer's software. Unfortunately, this radio is not Chirp compatible, and this software is not Chirp compatible. You cannot import CSV files or other files from Chirp. As far as I know, I haven't been able to figure out how to do that. But we're going to look at how to use the manufacturer's software, which is pretty simple and self-explanatory. So first of all, what we're going to do is we're going to read from the radio. And if we were going to do that, we would be clicking this button right here, read from radio. And I've already done that. So what I'm going to do instead is open the file that came with my radio. So I'm going to click on file and open. And as you see in this folder, I actually have three different files. They are VSF? The VSF files. So this one is one that came from the radio. This is one that I created myself that I read from the radio a while back. And this is one that a friend sent me who has the same radio and actually built off of his file because he had programmed in all the repeaters from the SARnet, which is the Florida State Amateur Radio Network, statewide network that we use here in Florida. And since, even though he's like 100, 200 miles away from me, he got a jump on that, and so that really helped me. But right now, I'm just going to click this file here. I'm going to open, and this is what it would look like if you were reading directly from the radio. There are 40 channels pre-programmed in. There's a 200-channel capacity on this radio. At least that's what the specs say, but coming from China, those things aren't always correct. So you can come in here and you can delete these pre-programmed frequencies individually or just write over them. You can write to them directly from the radio itself using the controls on the front panel or on the microphone. In fact, I've already created another video on how to program the radio directly from the mic. And it's pretty simple, but it's still easier to do this from the software. Let me do say that this is a Windows-based software only. I have not been able to find a way to do it on Mac, and I'm a Mac person myself, so I'm borrowing my wife's Windows computer. Another thing I don't like about it, but you know, what can you do? The radio cost me like $42. I'm playing the game here. You can change these frequencies just simply by double clicking on it. And then you have the ability to change this frequency to whatever you want. Now notice this is the receive frequency. Over here is the transmit frequency. If you're doing simplex, you would just simply use the same frequency. If you're programming a repeater, then you need to know what your offset is. And so your receive is generally the frequency that the repeater is known for. And then the transmit is you would increase the transmit frequency by whatever the offset is. So for example, this one here is set to be a simplex, but if it was a repeater with a 5 megahertz offset, then it would be 456.5200 megahertz over here. Over here, this is where you do your tones, and it's very important that you know, does your repeater require a transmit tone only or receive and a transmit tone? So it's not obvious here, but DE stands for decode. So this is where you would enter a receive tone. ENC stands for encode, and this is where you would enter a transmit tone. And just to give this a couple of clicks, then you'll see a drop down arrow and you can choose the frequency of the tone that you need for your repeater. Over here in this column, this is for your transmit power. The Hiroyasu has two options, high and low. High is supposed to be 25 watts or somewhat close to it. Low can be maybe 10 to 15 watts, maybe around 10 watts. I don't know. You can do your own testing and see what you get with it. Bandwidth. This particular repeater is a wide bandwidth. Some people use low bandwidth. So just know what works best for your repeater. Scan. You have add and delete as your options here. Add simply adds it to the scan. Delete does not remove it and does not remove the channel from memory, but it deletes it from scan mode, so it won't be picked up. If you choose delete right here and you set your radio to scan, this particular frequency, this channel, will not come in when you are scanning. And then busy inhibit is just something if you want to use this. I don't like it, but what it would do, it would keep you from transmitting over somebody else if the frequency is already being used. I've had this on before, and I would send out a call, and after I keyed up my mic, somebody else started talking, and it blocked me from transmitting, and I had no idea that my call didn't go out. So some people like it, I don't, but this is where you would choose it. Once again, just double click, and you'll see the drop down, and you'll see a couple of choices, actually, DQT, CAT, I'm not sure what those are. If you use it, I'm sure you'll figure it out. Special DCS, I have no idea what that is. Don't use it, but if you do and you know what it is, put a comment down below. From what I understand about that is that both receivers would have to have this enabled. If you're using a repeater, it probably won't work. If you're doing simplex, if the other person you're talking to has Compander turned on, then maybe it'll work. But I just hear a lot of complaints about it. And if your signal drops out after a while, this might be something you want to turn off. Scramble, from what I understand, scrambling in the United States is scrambling a ham radio frequency signal is illegal, so you would want to have that turned off. And over here is just where you enter the channel name. You can right now it's got the channel number, but you can change it to whatever you want. You can use numbers, you can type in the frequency, use channel number, or you could do just whatever you want to call it, Fred's repeater. And that's how many, that's how many spaces you're allowed to use. Okay, if you were done, then you would click here to write to radio. But before you do that, you may want to come over here and click on optional features right here. You're going to see you can enter in your A and B VFO frequency information. I never use that, but down here, this is what you want to look at. Key beep. This is when if you're using the handheld mic to program your radio or to make any changes, it would beep every time you push a button, and that just lets you know that it's working. This beep does not go out over the air. Show channel name, that channel name that's in the right column. This would allow it to show on the screen, so you can have that checked if you want. Single frequency mode, I'm not really sure what that is, because it also has double watch, which I do not have checked here. I do not like dual watch. I do not like it, Sam I Am. I do not like it when I'm eating green eggs and ham, but some of you do. However, on this radio, it's important to know that if you have dual watch enabled and you have a VHF frequency on channel A and a UHF frequency on channel B or vice versa, it's going to make a clicking sound. There's a relay, a mechanical relay that clicks when it switches bands. And so it's going to go click, 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 click. And maybe you've already experienced that and you're wondering why that's happening. If you disable dual watch, then that will go away. But it'll still be there when you're scanning, if you're scanning back and forth between VHF and UHF. If you're going to use dual watch, you can put both frequencies on the same band and you won't hear the clicking sound. So some people just say disable dual watch and it won't click. Well, you can also only use one band when you're using a dual watch, or when you're scanning. If you're only using one band, then you're not going to hear the click, click, click. Let's see, lock-in channel mode. I'm not sure what that is. Over here, there's some other changes. You can change the squelch here. And looks like you got one from 9, 1 to 9. I hear there's not a lot of difference on this particular radio in changing the squelch, but there is a secret menu, I believe, that you can go in and adjust that even further. We'll talk about that at another time. Scan resume. This is you have the typical choices. It could be time, carrier, or seek. Time, your scan will resume after a certain amount of time. Carrier, it will resume after the somebody drops off that frequency, and then seek, it will just keep going when you scan. I believe that's how that works. I like carrier myself. Priority scan, I never use that. I'm not sure what you would use that for. Key lock, I don't know. A lamp control, on, off, or you can set a timer. So this is the menu light, lighting up the radio itself. Me, I leave it on all the time because I'm not worried about running down a battery. This radio draws such a, it has such a low voltage, draws a low voltage that you can keep it on. But if you're worried about running out of battery, then you can have it set to auto, off and on. AB switch, you can have it on, off, or auto. And I just use it on, then I manually switch. Auto, I'm not sure what that does. Somebody had done a test to see if you had it on auto, would it automatically switch frequencies to the one that last transmitted? And it didn't work. They didn't seem to make any difference. But if you figure out how to use that, more power to you. Leave a message in the comments. Let us know how it works. APO, I'm not sure what that is. Power on message. You actually have three lines here. So the default is welcome. You can come in here and type in, my cursor's wigging out. You can type in your call sign. N4GPA. You can type in another message underneath that. You know, your name if you want. On that second line, it's wigging out. Okay, so that's what that's for. You can, and then you can type in actually a third line that would show up on the display when you turn the radio on, and it'll be on the, that one will show up on the bottom right hand corner. Language, you can choose between English, Chinese, English for me. Roger beep, I leave it off. If you're using repeaters, some require that you have no Roger beep. If you leave it on, somebody's going to fuss at you and tell you to turn it off, and that's how you get to it through the programming software. It's also very easy to get to it using the buttons on the radio or the mic itself. Mic, you have a home channel. Oh, but you can choose a home channel. I'm not sure what good that is because when you turn the radio off and then turn it back on, it automatically goes to the last channel. Not sure what that is good for. If you find out, let me know in the comments. Mic, you have two options. You have in hand and you have device host. This radio actually comes with a built-in mic on the front control panel. It's a very small mic. It has very low gain. And so in order to use it, you would have to put your mouth all the way up on the radio itself. But I do hear that if you get into the secret menu, you can adjust mic gain. I don't know if it affects the built-in mic or not. So if you want to use the handheld mic like you would with most mobile radios, then you would want to choose in hand. If that mic, if it ever got lost or broken, and chances of you ever finding another mic to replace it are low. So if you can order one now, go ahead. You know, if something happened to that mic, it's not working, your radio is still good because you could use the built-in mic. It'd just be a little bit awkward driving down the street with a mobile radio up against your face. Denoise, I like denoise. This is one of the great features of this radio. This is that supposedly AI-generated background noise cancellation. From what I understand, it only works on transmitting, not receiving. But I heard a guy do a test. He had his FM broadcast radio on while he was using his Hiroyasu IC-980 Pro. And he turned on denoise and it totally blocked out all of that background noise. And all you heard was the dude talking on his mic. So I think it's a great feature. I would like to leave it on. And then power on mode, you have three choices. That, let's say you have this in your vehicle or hooked up to a power supply. You turn that power supply or vehicle on. If it's in an off mode, the radio, you'll hear a noise that it's powered up, but it will not actually come on. If it's in on mode, every time you turn the power supply on or start your car, the radio is coming on. And if it's in auto, it will do whatever it did the last time you used it. So if you shut the radio off before you turned your car off, when you turn your car on, the radio will still be off. If you kept your radio on before you turned your car off, then when you turn your car back on, the radio will still be on. I have my daughter sitting right here next to me, and she hates it. that I had this radio set to on, and every time her and my wife got into the luxury minivan that picks her up and takes her to school, and the radio would come on and people would be squawking and everything, and she hated that. So now I have it set to off in the luxury minivan, and she's over here nodding, so that you have to intentionally turn the radio on in order for it to come on. All right, one last thing. See this over here? This 1750 hertz hold. Oh, make sure that that's turned off. Otherwise, every time you key up your mic, it's gonna transmit a loud beep. I'm not sure why you would want that, but if that's happening to you, make sure that that's turned off. Last thing, excuse me. After you're all done, you want to write to your radio, and you will click there. I don't have my radio hooked up, so I'm not going to write to it. But this one on the right is write to radio. And then you also have these buttons up here. Like, I think the edit will give you the same choices. Read from radio, write to radio. You can set a password. You can do all kinds of things. Somewhere in here is a button that you could click and go to the secret, enter the secret code, and get to the secret menus. There's actually, I think, three or four different secret menus. One of these days, we may address that. Last thing is, if you want to save this file before you exit, you can do that. Save it to your computer, or otherwise just exit, and it'll give you the option of saving the file before you exit. Save it or delete it. Okay, that's all for now. Thank you for watching, and I hope you enjoy your Hiroyasu IC-980 Pro. This is in for GPA and 73, y'all. I'm clear.